All right, so the old yellow Cub Cadet bit the dust after 15 years. It needed a crankshaft, and of course, that wasn't worth sinking the money into it. And I settled on buying this because, I mean, this was $300, which, of course, with the cost of everything these days, couldn't find anything without a Briggs & Stratton engine locally for sale, so I kind of had to go with that. And I had one with these primer bulbs in the middle of the air filter before, 7 years ago. Not crazy about them. It's an all plastic carburetor, but well, I couldn't go spend $500 on a mower. So my Honda has gone up about 25% since I bought it last year, and given that, you know, this is just something I'm keeping here at Mother's house. So far, so good. I have cut that over there. I had the wheels, I raised the wheel height since then, but I cut along the, what you northerners would call the tree lawn. I cut along that, and I was kind of concerned because this engine is only 5 foot-pounds of torque. And I said, gee, that's kind of low, but the grass is a little damp. It's handling everything so far. That was as high as this. And it's either got a size discharge or it's a mulcher. It's not a great mulcher, but nevertheless, it's actually getting the job done without fighting me any. So I'll go through some of this high grass here to give y'all a visual. This is an MNA 152702, 21 inch. Of course, Murray went out of business years ago. Made in Thailand. How you like that? Manufactured by Lingai Intelligent Thailand Company Limited. So they give you two manuals, one for the mower and one for the engine. The engine is assembled in the United States out of foreign and domestic parts. Just looks like your typical Briggs engine, cheapo Briggs engine from the last several years. Of course, the wheels all mount to plastic. We'll see how that holds up. It's one lever on each side to adjust the height, which is convenient. ...140cc. I know they're still selling a 125cc job. I've seen some of those. And got our California stuff on there. So, oh, it's got the high wheels on the back. I didn't even notice that until right now. Well, I mean, out the box, you had to screw the handle together, pour the oil in, pour the gas in, set your wheel height, and you're ready to go. So,
thank you.
So, as we can see, well, the grass is a little damp. So it's really not mulching very well, but it is getting through the high St. Aug over here without complaint and without bogging the engine down, which is what I was worried about. I wanted a self-propelled like the Honda. That was out of the budget with anything. Yeah, you're looking at $500 everywhere I went. And this thing is light enough where it's perfectly fine for me. It's a lot lighter than the old Cub Cadet was. So, thought I'd show y'all this thing and the decent job it's doing. It's, I guess for what the hell you get for your money today. I'm not complaining. I just hope I don't wind up having problems with that all-plastic carburetor like I was having back in 16-17 when I got rid of that little Poulon Pro. I think that was a 125, but anyhow, it's all the same stuff. It's that modern Briggs all-plastic carburetor. Yeah. Anyhow, alrighty guys.